Last week, Traction did a live stream where they went over some of their upcoming products, including updates to current instruments, plus some new instruments that they're going to be releasing. And they also talked a little bit about Traction Waveform 12. So I quickly want to go over what's been revealed so far, just in case you missed the live stream, because there's some cool additions coming to Waveform Free and Waveform Pro, including this one little feature that's going to save so much time. So stick around till near the end where I'll talk about that. But first, let's talk about the audio engine. They're saying that they've completely reworked the audio engine, so it's basically a whole new audio engine, and this is going to make our workflow a lot smoother. Now, in addition to that, all of the internal plugins have been reworked and updated, plus there's going to be some new plugins when you get Waveform 12. Now, you might be wondering if these new plugins will be included in Waveform Free or just Waveform Pro, and they did say that most of them will be in Waveform Free as well. So if you're using Waveform Free, you have something to look forward to. And I actually use some of the internal plugins, so I'm pretty excited to hear that they're updating them and they're giving them a little love, plus adding some more in there. I saw that they're adding this 8-band EQ that looks great. And they also mentioned something about some new reverbs that they're going to be adding. And another new effect that they actually showed was a dual guitar IR loader. So this is going to be like a guitar cabinet sim where you can load IRs in there. It probably comes with several IRs built into it, and I'm sure you'll be able to add your own. And I'm not sure, this might be one that's only included with Pro, but I'm just speculating on that. We'll have to see when Traction Waveform 12 is released. There's going to be a new micro sampler and a rompler instrument that they said is going to be like a preset instrument. So maybe they're going to work in some preset sounds from their premium instruments and you'll have access to that. It sounds like these are going to be in the free version. So there's some new instruments to look forward to. Now, another cool thing for people that like to tinker with the user interface is that they're making it easier for you to change colors of various things. And they also have a ton of preset templates for different colors. So if you like to change the color of your user interface and customize it, there's going to be a lot of stuff coming for you, and they've made it very easy. They've also totally reworked the browser. So it's going to make it easier for you to search and find different samples, loops, presets, and bring those into your projects, or whatever it is you want to bring into your projects is going to be easier to do that from within the browser. So that's another update to look forward to. Also, if you use the MIDI editor or the step clip editor, they're doing some updates to that as well. You'll be able to show only the notes that are in the key that you're working in, so you won't be hitting any wrong notes, or you can set it to only show the current notes that you're using. And there will also be a drum grid available in the MIDI editor if that's something you want to use. You can switch between that. So some nice updates coming to the MIDI editor. And now the one thing that they announced that I'm really looking forward to testing out is the remove silence feature. And this is going to save me so much time. Now, normally I'll go through my vocal tracks and I'll slice them in various sections and then shorten the clip and add fades on both sides, and you have to go through the various sections of your song to remove all of those quiet parts so you're not getting any background sounds in there or maybe breathing, something like that. Normally I go through manually and do that. This new remove silence feature is going to allow me to do that for the entire vocal clip in just 2 clicks. So it's going to save so much time. It's going to add all of the fades, clip it where there's all the silence in there, and you can even set the threshold so you can make sure that it's getting the right stuff and it's not cutting off any of your vocal, or maybe it's going to leave a little too much of the silence. You can set the threshold however you want, and it shows you where it's going to chop. So you get a visual of where it's going to chop, and then you know where you want to set it. So that remove silence feature alone is worth the update for me. Now, they didn't really give an exact date of when Waveform 12 is going to be released, but they did say next month. So could be at the beginning of March, maybe at the end of March, maybe at the beginning of April. I guess it all depends on when it's actually ready to be released. You don't want them releasing it full of bugs. They want to make sure all of that stuff's taken care of. Now, if you're wondering if it's worth it to upgrade to Waveform Pro from Waveform Free, click the video on the screen where I'll show you some of the differences. And if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.